Let's learn the books of the Bible. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers and Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job and Psalms and Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Songs. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible because we love God's Word. Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel and Daniel, Hosea, Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum.
Oh, hey, what do you say? We're gonna rock a jam in a major way. Oh, hey, what do you say? We're gonna rock a jam in a major way.
Chocolate ice cream. What? Why do you think I'm thankful for that? That doesn't sound very good. It doesn't seem like something that is good or something to be thankful for. Well, it's important to stay thankful in times of hardship, not just when everything is going great. Because even when things are tough or not going our way, God is still blessing us through those times and working in His miraculous ways. Let me ask you this. Why aren't we thankful when bad things happen? It's a great question. But today, I'm going to tell you why you should be thankful when bad things happen. Ephesians 5:20 says, "And give thanks for everything to God, for the Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ." Take a minute, get your journals, and journal these questions. We'll talk about it at our live Zoom meeting this Wednesday. The first question is, why would God want us to thank Him for everything, meaning the good things and the bad things? Tell about a time you experienced something good right in the middle of something bad. And the last question, why aren't we thankful when bad things happen? And why do you think we should change this way of thinking? To give you some inspiration, here are some examples in my life when something bad happened, but it turned out to be for the best. Now, there was a time when I was running late and got a flat tire, so I missed my meeting. But I was encouraged by the kindness of someone who stopped to help me, and I was able to share the gospel with them. That really made my day. Even though I missed my meeting, I was able to share the good news of Jesus Christ with a complete stranger and even made a new friend that day. There was another time when my mom got really sick and she had to spend some time in the hospital. I was so sad and so worried for her. But since they ran all these tests at the hospital, they found another illness that they could treat right away so she wouldn't get really sick. Without those tests, we wouldn't have known that she was sick with this other illness that would have really hurt her very much if she didn't get treatment right away. So the fact that she got sick with something else was really a blessing in disguise because it sent her to the hospital where she got tests done and they found this other illness which may have ended up saving her life. The point is, it's easy to thank God for things that are going good, but we should remember to thank God for hard things too, because He often uses those bad things for good. Dear God, thank you for all of your amazing blessings and the work you do in our lives. Thank you for the Bible. Thank you for your love. Thank you for our families. Thank you for keeping us safe and happy and healthy. We love you so much. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.
My hands are searching for you, my arms are outstretched towards you, I feel you on my fingertips, my tongue dances behind my lips for you. This fire rising through my being, burning, I'm not used to seeing you.
Psalm 118 says, "Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His faithful love endures forever."
Let all Israel repeat, his faithful love endures forever. Let Aaron's descendants, the priests, repeat, his faithful love endures forever. Let all who hear the Lord repeat, his faithful love endures forever. In my distress, I prayed to the Lord, and the Lord answered me and set me free. The Lord is for me, so I will have no fear. What can mere people do to me? Yes, the Lord is for me. He will help me. I will look in triumph at those who hate me. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in people. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes.
What does this mean? It means we should be thankful to God for protecting us and for loving us.
What does this mean? It means we should always trust in the Lord. We should be thankful to him. We can always trust him. He is our Lord and our King, and he will always triumph.
learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. Because we love God's Word.
You guys are doing great, but let's speed it up for the New Testament!
Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Acts, and Romans, 1st and 2nd Corinthians, Galatians, and Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1st and 2nd Thessalonians, 1st and 2nd Timothy, Titus, and Philemon. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible because we love God's Word.
Let's keep going, everybody! Hebrews and James!
Hebrews, James, 1st and 2nd Peter, 1st, 2nd, 3rd John, Jude and Revelation. Oh yeah, we did it! That's the New Testament. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible. We're gonna learn the books of the Bible because we love God's Word. Now we know the books of the Bible. Now we know the books of the Bible. Now we know the books of the Bible because we love God's Word.